Hi everybody and welcome back to the Cupcake Gemma channel and welcome to the Crumbs and Doilies kitchen here in London where I'm going to show you guys how to make a pumpkin pie because a few weeks back I asked you guys what kind of pie you wanted us to make next over on my Instagram account and the majority of you said pumpkin pie because it is the season and there are pumpkins all over the place so it feels right that we should make this. So we're going to start where all pies start and that is with the pie crust. We made this pie crust a few weeks ago when we did our chocolate silk pie so I'm just going to run through it fairly quickly and I'll give you a few key hints to watch out for along the way. So I'm making mine in my food processor here, but by all means you can make this by hand. You just want to watch out for the temperature of your hands. If you've got really hot hands, just cool them down every now and again under some cold water because the main thing we don't want to do here is melt the butter. So we're going to start with plain flour and I've got 255 grams of that and it's going to go into the food processor. And then into that we're going to add about half a teaspoon of salt. And then the butter. Now I've got 170 grams of unsalted butter and it's very, very cold. So what you want to do is cut your butter up ahead of time, put it back into the fridge or even into the freezer for like 10 minutes just to make sure that when we're putting it in, it is as cold as possible. And then we're going to go on with the lid and we're going to blast it just for a couple of seconds just to break that butter up. So if we have a little look inside, you can see that we've still got quite a few big old lumps of butter in here. And that is how we want it because now we're going to add some liquid. Now into this jug, I'm going to start with 1 tablespoon of cider vinegar, but you can use a white wine vinegar as well. And then we're going to add 5.5 tablespoons of ice cold water. So I had a few ice cubes sitting in this water, again, just to keep it all nice and cold. So in goes 5.5. So then I'm going to put in about 3/4 of this mixture. So I'm not adding all of this straight away because if it's too wet, then it's quite tricky to bring it back together. But if it's too dry, we can always add a little bit more liquid. So again, we're going to pulse this and see what it looks like after about 10 seconds. Now, if you pick up a little bit of your dough and it squishes together and holds itself, you're probably good to go. But as you can see, mine's slightly crumbly, so I am going to add the rest of my liquid and then I'm just going to blast it for about 5 seconds and then we are ready. Now we can tip this out onto our surface. I'm just going to dust it with a little bit of plain flour first. And we're going to start by bringing it together into one ball. And once it's together, I'm just going to knead it ever so slightly just to make sure it has all come together. Just like that, so really, really quick. And now we need to let this cool down because it's really soft right now and we want this to be nice and firm because remember we're trying not to let the butter melt. So I've got some cling film over here. I'm just gonna wrap it up and we're gonna go and pop it in the fridge. Ideally, you would make this a day before or even up to a week before you can keep it in the fridge, but 2 hours minimum, I would say. We just want to make it nice and firm before we roll it out. I have got some chilling in the fridge already, so I'll go and do a switcheroo. And once your dough has completely chilled and it's nice and firm, we can get rolling. So again, make sure you dust your surface with a bit of flour because otherwise it's just gonna stick. I like to put a tiny bit on top as well. Now we need a pie dish. So I've got this lovely little small, I think it's 8 inch because I mean, we can't really have pies with more than 6 people at the moment here in the UK, but I will give you a few different quantity options in the description box below. So what we need to do is we need to roll our dough out to at least this size, because remember, it needs to go down the sides as well, and we want a little bit overhanging so that we can use that for our crust. So we better get rolling. Now, what we're gonna do first is we're gonna do one nice big roll forwards and backwards. And then we're gonna turn it 90 degrees and we're gonna do the same thing and we're gonna keep doing that. This way, hopefully, your dough will stay in a nice round shape. I think think mine is looking pretty good. So I'm going to test it by grabbing my pie dish back, putting it upside down, and look, I've got loads of space all around the edge. So the first thing we're going to do is cut off some of this excess, because if it's too much, it's going to be really hard once we get it into the dish. So I'm going to cut off from about 1 inch around the edge of the dish. And now just take off the excess. And this is excess, and if you don't want to throw it away, you can by all means bake this. You can like spread, things I've done is spread chutney or pesto on them and bake them. So nice little snack for you there. But with this, we're going to take our dish off, and now we need to get the pastry inside. So like I said before, if you're feeling brave, you can pick this up with your hands. But if you're a little bit scared, which is totally fine, grab back your rolling pin. You're going to flip your pastry over it like this, and then you're going to pick it up, and we haven't even touched the pastry once. And now we're going to roll it across the top of our tin. Now to get this into the dish, you want to be really, really careful. If you've got long nails, this can be slightly problematic. So I like to use the back of my finger like this, and I'm very gently pushing into the crease of the tin, trying as I go to make sure that the excess is nice and even around the dish. And next, what we're going to do is grab the lip of our pastry, and we're going to fold it under like this. And by now, your pastry might have warmed up a little bit, which is totally fine. What we would do in that case is take it like this, put it in the fridge for about 20 minutes, just to harden that butter up again before we do the crimping. But I'm going to crack on and show you that crimping now. We're going to use two fingers on one hand, one finger on the other, and I'm going to push in opposite directions, just like this. Now, I think that looks pretty awesome. So now we need to prepare this for baking. Now, baking pie crusts can be completely different depending on what kind of pie you're doing. When we did our chocolate silk pie a few weeks ago, the pie filling was a cold filling, so we weren't baking it, so we completely baked the crust on its own. This time, we need to bake our filling, but I'm still gonna par-bake this, which means we're gonna put it in for about 15 minutes just to crisp it up a little bit, because sometimes if you put the filling in and it hasn't been kind of par-baked, it can be all a little bit too soggy. So that is my top tip, and it's definitely worth the extra time and effort. So first of all, what we need to do is put some holes all around the inside of the pie dish and up the side. And next up, we're going to fill this with baking beans, or like I like to use is some rice. And you can see I've used this rice a lot, and that's the best thing about it, is that you can use it to blind bake and reuse it. And I've also got a bit of greaseproof paper here, which I used the last time I made pie as well. So again, nice to reuse these things. We're going to shove this all inside the pie, making sure that it's enough to cover the edges as well, because we don't want the kind of pie crust bit here to get too hot and burnt. So I'm folding over my baking paper so that it covers that as well, and then I'm going to fill it almost all the way to the top with this rice. I'm just pushing it down with my hand to make sure that it gets into all the creases of our pie. And now I'm actually going to put this in the fridge for another 20 minutes, because again, it's had time to warm up and I want to bake it straight from the fridge, so it's really, really cold. I've got my oven set to 190 degrees C. That's with a fan, and it's really hot, and that's really important that it's at that temperature. And I'm going to start by baking this for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, I'm going to very carefully remove it from the oven, and I'm going to take out my rice using the corners of my baking parchment and just dump that into a bowl. And now I've got a little bit of egg wash, and I'm just brushing the bottom of the pie dish, not the sides, and this is just going to help keep the bottom nice and crispy. And now we're going to return it to the oven for a further 5 minutes. Okay, so now that our pie crust is par-baked, we're gonna let it cool down and get on with making our pumpkin pie filling. So the first thing you're gonna need is some pumpkin. So you want some pumpkin puree, just like this. Now you can get this in a can, and if you can get hold of it, then fantastic. It's great stuff, it's 100% pumpkin, but here in the UK, it is absolutely impossible to find at this time of year because everybody's after it. But something that there is an abundance of in all stores is pumpkins, and this is all you need to make some pumpkin puree. It is super, super easy, but the main thing you want to look out for is that you look for a cooking pumpkin, not one of those big old ones that are grown to be big, because they're not going to taste very nice. They probably won't have much flavor at all. So if you can get hold of a little one like this, perfect. And all you need to do is start by setting your oven to 165 degrees C. That is fan assisted. And now very carefully chop in half your pumpkin and scoop out all the seeds from the center. But don't throw them away, because you can roast these and they're super delicious. So just pop them in a bowl with any of the stringy bits of flesh. Sprinkle the inside of your pumpkins with a little bit of salt, just to help draw out some liquid and also to add an extra bit of flavor. Turn them upside down and pop them into your oven. Now leave these in for at least 1 hour, and in the meantime you can get on with washing those seeds. Give them a good rinse under some water and then dry them out on a clean tea towel or with a bit of paper towel. Once they've dried, you can pop them in the oven. You can sprinkle them with salt or some sugar. Loads of things you can do with these, and you can snack on them, so do not throw them away. After an hour, grab a fork and give your pumpkins a little squeeze. If they look lovely and soft like this, you can take them out of the oven. If they still feel firm, leave them in for a further 5 to 10 minutes. Once the pumpkins have cooled down for about 10 to 15 minutes, very carefully scoop the center out with a spoon, and then transfer it to a food processor if you have one, and blitz it up to a really smooth puree. And that is it, homemade pumpkin puree. And once it's cooled down, it is ready to use. So this is a very, very easy pie filling to make. You want to grab yourself a nice large bowl, and into it we're going to add 65 grams of light brown sugar and 45 grams of caster sugar. And into that we're going to add 2 large free range, if possible, eggs. Yes! Now grab yourself a whisk and we're going to mix those together. Next up, we're gonna go for a whole teaspoon of good quality vanilla extract. And remember, you can get yours from cupcakegemma.com. I'll put a link to that in the description box below as well. And then just give that a little whisk. And now we're gonna go in with our pumpkin. So I've got 330 grams of pumpkin puree, which is the amount that I got from this little guy here. So you only need a pumpkin about this size. So let's put all of our puree into the bowl. And again, give those a quick whisk together. When we're making this recipe, we don't need to whip anything particularly. We're just kind of combining it all and making it nice and smooth. So now we can go in with some spices, which is super important in a pumpkin pie. You can kind of do whatever you like here, but what I like to do is I've got 1 rounded teaspoon of ground cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of ginger, and 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg, and they are all going in the bowl. And once they've all mixed together, we're gonna go in with a good pinch of salt. You know what I think about salt, guys. It brings out all those flavors. And finally, 115 grams of double cream. Now that it's all mixed together, look how beautiful it is. It's such a gorgeous color. And it smells amazing too. So we can grab back our pie crust, and you can see where we did our egg wash, it's gone lovely and golden and it's nice and crisp. That means that because we've got a very wet filling here, the base of our pie isn't gonna be soggy. Like Mary Berry says, no one likes a soggy bottom. So now just fill up your pie crust. So just give it a little jiggle, just to flatten it out and make it nice and smooth on top. And before we bake it, we're gonna add the egg wash to the outside of our pie so that that goes lovely and golden as well. So in here is just 1 egg with about 1 tablespoon of milk whisked together. And then I'm using this pastry brush, but you can use a paintbrush. You could probably even just do this with your fingers. And I'm very lightly painting the crust. I can already tell how flaky this pastry is. It's gonna be incredible. But obviously we need to bake this. So back into the oven, but this time we want it at 170 degrees. So turn it down, because we had it at 190, remember? And we're gonna put it in for 35 to 40 minutes. When it's ready, if you give it a jiggle, it'll have an ever so slightly jiggly center, but the outside will be nice and firm. I'll show you what it looks like when it's baked. How good does this pie look? It is absolutely beautiful. It's so shiny on top. We've got this bit of caramelization going on here. That pastry looks like it is the flakiest pastry in the world. And I know it's going to be buttery and it's going to melt in our mouths. So if you want to eat yours just like this, then go ahead. But I like to top mine off. So you could do this with a bit of cream or Chantilly cream. But I'm going to add a tiny bit of cream cheese into mine and a bit of icing sugar, a little bit of a frosting going on because cream cheese and pumpkin is a winning combination. We have a cupcake flavor over at C&D Soho that is a spiced pumpkin sponge and it's got cream cheese frosting and it is to die for. So that's what I'm going for in this topping. So in this bowl, I've got a really small amount of cream cheese and it's lovely and soft. And in this bowl, I've got some double cream, which I whipped up. It's still quite loose. I'm gonna combine the two. We're gonna dump in a little bit of icing sugar and then we're gonna whip it until we get the consistency that we can pipe with. Now it looks so cute. We've got to eat it and we've got to try and get a nice clean pie slice out. So let's give this a go, shall we? This is the cutest bit of pie. It's because I baked it in such a small tin because, you know, the rule of six and whatnot, but oh, this looks amazing. Look how soft that looks and it looks super consistent. And obviously that pastry looks incredible. It's just so, so smooth. It's kind of like a mousse. And the spices, it's the perfect combination of cinnamon to ginger to nutmeg. It is absolutely delicious. And I would really recommend going for this cheesy, creamy topping because that extra bit of tang really contrasts with the pie itself. The pastry is cooked perfectly because we did our par baking. This is the perfect pumpkin pie, guys. Honestly, you don't need to go anywhere else but here for your Thanksgiving pies. Mmm. And you can also eat this cold or room temperature, however you like it. I like mine to be cold. You can probably eat it warm. Don't know. Might have to fact check that one. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this recipe. I hope you love making this pie. I'm desperate to make more pies, so do let me know what you want. I really want to do an apple pie. Sam really wants to do a cherry pie. What do you want us to do? And in the meantime, well, actually, next week, I'm pretty sure that someone else might be coming to do a recipe with you guys. I don't want to make too many promises because things are changing day by day, but hopefully my fabulous friend Dane Pemberton will be here with a cupcake recipe for you guys. So he'll see you next Thursday and I'll be back sometime after that once I've eaten all this pie. So I'll see you soon. Bye. Mmm! Thanks for the bell!